time, Joanie Rochette is in the unfamiliar position of playing catch-up in the Olympic season. Five times the champ, she's second now to this woman, Cynthia Phaneuf, who as a kid won the title in Edmonton in 2004. Today, they're both reaching for a dream in London. The rink resonates with reasons to believe in Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer, Canadians on their way to the big dance. In the precocious Patrick Chan, whose Olympic odyssey has many twists and turns. In lady stars like Cynthia Phaneuf, a champion reborn. And the grand dame of Canadian skating, Joanie Rochette, who searches for six today. Return now to the hot white ice of the John Labatt Centre in downtown London and the BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships on CBC. This weekend is all about getting to the big dance known as the Olympics. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to London. Championship figure skating on CBC Sports Weekend continues. I'm Scott Russell. We've got a busy 2 hours of skating, a critical 2 hours for the skaters themselves as they aspire to the Olympic Games. We're working our way towards the ladies' free program and a forced comeback performance on the part of five-time Canadian champion Joanie Rochette. We'll also check in on Patrick Chan and his interesting journey. We'll convene our special figure skating panel. But first, the highly anticipated original dance featuring the local heroes Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer. And with more on that, here's Brenda Irving.
Well, Scott, you know, two teams can go to the Olympics for Canada. You have to think that Tessa Virtue, Scott Moyer are virtual locks for one of those spots. The other spot, though, a fight between two teams with very different histories.
Teenagers Vanessa Crone and Paul Poirier may be young, but they have a long-standing partnership, which has lasted 9 years. This team had a successful sophomore Grand Prix season, finishing with a bronze medal and a trip to their very first Grand Prix final.
We really focused on getting the expression level up and bigger movements, and we think we've had a lot of success with that so far. And every competition, we've gotten stronger and stronger and more comfortable with our programs.
Caitlin Weaver and Andrew Poggi teamed up just 4 years ago, and this summer, the pair cleared an important Olympic hurdle when American-born Caitlin received her Canadian citizenship. Now the 20-something skaters face another daunting task, finishing higher than Crone and Poirier. Despite winning their first Grand Prix medal in November, Weaver and Poggi have sat neck and neck with their younger rivals this season.
The competition being so close has really motivated us. I don't think that we would have been as good if we didn't know that, you know, we could be this close to number two, and we believe in ourselves, and we believe we have what it takes to really succeed at this competition and make the Olympic team.
Well, just how close are these teams? If you look at their season best total scores, they are just 0.2 points separate the teams, and after the compulsories, just 0.4 points separate them. Right now, let's head to Jeff Merrick, who's standing by with the Moyer clan. Jeff.
Yeah, thank you very much, Brendan. If you look around the John Labatt Center, you'll see about 100 of these red T-shirts. Believe Vancouver 2010, Virtue and Moyer standing here with the mother and father of Scott Moyer. This is Joe and Alma. Dad, we'll start with you. It's a rowdy bunch. We'll start with you. If there's strength in numbers, you must have the field licked. How does the team feel today?
Great. We feel great. Got about 50 family members here that are going to be help cheering us
and
on.
Friends.
And friends, for sure. And it's great atmosphere here in London. They're all, we can feel all of their love and support come from all of them.
How does it feel, Mom, this close to the Olympics?
Ask me after they skate.
One final question for you. Confirm or deny, as close as these two are, and we love watching them skate, as close as they are now, when they were kids driving in the car to skating, they wouldn't even talk to each other.
That's true, they didn't.
Thanks so much. Good luck tonight.
Thank you very much.
Make some noise, Moyers. Back to you, Scott Russell, from a rowdy bunch.
Thanks very much, Jeff Merrick, Tessa Virtue, and Scott Moyer, Tracy Wilson, and Kurt Browning. This seems a little bit like a coronation, doesn't it?
Well, it is for the end result. There's pretty much no doubt that they will be the victors in the competition. But for Tessa and Scott, what they're going to be very interested in is the results on the judging sheet. In particular, the levels of technical difficulty awarded to the elements by the technical specialist. They dropped a couple levels at the Grand Prix final, and that allowed Davis and White of the United States to go ahead of them. They are going to need all of those levels if they are to challenge for gold at the games.
Kurt, they battled through injury last season. Are they as good as you've seen them so far this season?
I think that they're growing. Each time that they step out, they learn, they make a mistake, and they learn. So as long as, like you say, Tracy, as long as you're going up towards the Olympic Games, then that's what's important. It seems to be what's happening here.
The youngsters, Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poirier, are in second. A bit of a surprise there, but in a close battle with Weaver Pogier.
As always, a close battle with those two teams. You've got Krohn and Poirier, who are the technical specialists. Weaver and Pogier, the artists. We'll see what it comes down to in this original dance.
So it stands after the compulsory dance, Tessa Virtue, Scott Moyer, Vanessa Krohn, Paul Poirier in second spot, Caitlin Weaver and Andrew Pogier a close third, heading to the original dance.
The next competitors represent the Sioux and Kitchener Warner Blue Skating Clubs in Northern Ontario. Please welcome Caitlin Weaver and Andrew Pogier.
Well, you talk about great depth in Canadian ice dancing. Great youth as well. Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poirier are young. So too are Caitlin Weaver and Andrew Pogier. She's 20. He's only 22, and they do have world championship experience in 07 in Tokyo.
Tempo for the original dance this season is the folk dance, and coincidentally, the top three Canadian teams that you will see have all chosen to skate to flamenco. Not the variety for the audience, but it does allow one to compare apples with apples. Notice the use of a prop. As long as that stays attached to the body, it is allowed.
Like magic, the prop is gone.
Hidden for now. Four required elements. The second they're executing here, twizzles on one foot. Excellent. Their weakness sometimes when they perform is that they skate tentatively and hold back. So far, they're skating in exactly the right place. Aggressive, yet controlled.
Coached by the 2003 World Ice Dance Champion, Shailen Bourne, along with Pasquale Camerlengo.
They have wonderful body lines, very fluid and graceful skaters. They went to Spain to learn the authentic flamenco. They did a good job of taking it to the ice. Normally a static dance. This working well.
Pogier, after the compulsory dance, just fractions away from where they want to be.
Ladies and gentlemen,
A good original dance for these two at the John Labatt Center. When we return, the former World Junior silver medalist, teenagers Vanessa Krohn and Paul Porritt. Back to the John Labatt Center in London and the BMO Canadian Championships. Another look at Caitlin Weaver, Andrew Poggi.
Kurt, I liked the use of the prop, in this case, the fan in this program. Sometimes a prop can be distracting. I thought it worked here.
It did work here, and actually a prop can be dangerous because it just simply brings up the danger level and not necessarily adding to it. I thought that it weaved itself into the program. Weaver, pun intended.
Technically, they're looking to up their levels here. Here's a look at their Twizzle section. They've only received level 2 this year in competition. We'll see if they get a level 4 here. The difference between a 2 and a 4 is a point and a half.
And in this competition that's
Olympics
everything.
Or not.
And this is maybe the best I've seen Caitlin skate, I must say. It was free and reckless and near the end. A look on her face of pure confidence, and that is so important in the dance event.
And something we've been missing from them in competition.
Original dance score of 57.92 for Weaver Poggi. Make the total now 94.79 into first place.
And they got the level on the Twizzles of level 4. Very important bonus for them here.
Talk about throwing down the gauntlet.
Represent the Scarborough Figure Skating Club in Central Ontario. Please welcome Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poggi.
Now, here are the teenagers, Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poirier. Last year's silver medalists at the Nationals in Saskatoon and went to the Grand Prix final this year in Tokyo.
One thing this team has shown us in competition is they typically love to compete. As we mentioned at the top, technically a very strong team. Both of them have a background in single skating. And you can land triple jumps in competition. A Twizzle's not so tough.
That's it. I'll leave the Twizzles to you, Tracy.
Thanks, Kurt. Look how they get down in the knees here. A lot of speed, deep curves across the ice. Wonderful transitions.
And I'm also noticing they're not looking for each other. Sorry, Tracy, but they're not looking for each other out of the corner of their eyes, keeping focused and yet staying close.
Like Virtue and Moyer, this team has been a couple for 10 years.
They are out of the Scarborough Figure Skating Club, coached by Carolyn John Lane, Yuri Razguleyev.
Efficiency. One or two strides, and they're scooting across the ice. A lot of work there on one foot. Original dance in competition. It looked like a whole new dance for me. I know new costume, but they just came together. A very
fluid dance for Vanessa and Paul.
And what a quick rise to prominence. They were second in 08 at the Junior Worlds, and they stood on the podium this Grand Prix season at NHK in Nagano, Japan. Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poirier. Next, a triumphant homecoming for Tessa Virtue and Scott Moore. Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poirier representing Central Ontario, and another look at what has been a great original dance performance.
Well, speaking of bold, Kurt, these two have the boldest of edges.
Well, you mentioned them as teenagers. From the first few seconds of this program, I thought they were flamenco, they were mature. And the boldest of edges, as you say, they do fire out of that corner and they build up speed so quickly.
The one criticism and the area that this team still has to work to get to the top of the world standing, they have quite a bit of space between them. Every now and then they could get a little bit closer together. But splitting hairs here. Also, we have a technical panel of three specialists. These are international caliber, and they will be tough on the skaters, and it's going to come into play. They got a level two on a footwork sequence that they need to get a level three on. And that's going to put them just behind Krohn and just behind Weaver and Poge in the OD. Very close.
Just.
Whoa.
Two 100s. It's a virtual tie. But now Krohn and Poirier are back of Weaver Poge.
But I think it's right, because you can't, you look at both teams come out, they both laid it down.
And it's just going to get better.
Well, this is like the dessert after the main meal, isn't it?
Great reception for Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer.
Hometown.
She's 20 from London. He's 22 from the tiny place of Ilderton, just outside the city of London. their parents and family in the crowd. World championship bronze medalists. Golden potential from Ontario Southwest, Tessa Virtue and Scott Boyer.
Doesn't get better than that. Artistically, they were in exactly the right place. That is what they wanted to do. They were in the zone, Kurt, where they could play with their performance. They could play with the blade and with their expression.
Well, you want, as a spectator and as a fan, you want to watch a skater look like they're not thinking. They just are. They're not skating. They just are. And I think especially in the last 25 seconds of that program, Scott was doing things with his blades that I don't think is allowed in physics class. It was pretty great.
And that is such a luxury. When you're doing a technical exercise like this and it becomes a game. Now, very, very technical though for the panel that is assessing
dissecting,
edges,
shall we
yes.
say?
They're looking for level 3 or level 4 in this circular step sequence. And what the judges are watching is the blade on the ice. Are they difficult turns? This, the Twizzle, they had a level 3 at the Grand Prix Final. They need a level 4 for gold in Vancouver. Bang on there. Again.
The arms going up and down in unison, adding to the difficulty. This beautiful lift.
Tessa Virtue and Scott Moyer, along with their coach Marina Zueva, they train in Canton, Michigan, with their American rivals, Merrill Davis and Charlie White. Here are the scores in the original dance, way out there, 70.15.
Well, we knew the judges would be generous with the scores, but I tell you, the technical specialists generally are not, and they have all level 4s. That is exactly the message they want sent to them and the rest of the world going to the games.
Well, a great homecoming for Virtue Moyer and the standings after the OD. It is Virtue Moyer, the defending Canadian champions in full flight. In the struggle for second, the other Olympic spot, Caitlin Weaver, Andrew Poggé, they have a slight edge over Vanessa Krohn and Paul Poirier. Here's Brenda.
Well, Tessa and Scott, your best ever performance of that original dance.
Yeah, it felt great. I mean, it's how we've been training it at home. This program has really come a long way. I'm really pleased with the way we performed it.
At the top of the show, we spoke with Elma and Joe, your parents. We saw all of your fans. I know that your parents are here as well. All of the fans and all of the family and friends, is it a distraction or motivation here at these national championships?
It's a little bit of both. No, Tessa and I are really embracing it, having everybody here at the JLC. It's so much fun. We're creating memories that we're never going to forget for us, so we thank them so much for the support, but it's also a good positive distraction, which will be hopefully similar to the games in Vancouver, because you're going to know a lot of people, so we're using it as positive as we can.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Now let's go back to Scott.